Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. I recently did a video about incrementally loading my data warehouse using a pattern with data flows and some pipelines, all inspired by Mr. Alex Pyrus himself with his blog post that it's not about a sale. And I watched the video and I was like, wait a minute, I didn't finish. I didn't tell him what happens to that incremental data. And so now I gotta do another video. It's kind of like a two-parter now, to tell you exactly what's going on when you run the data flow that's executed by the pipeline. I gotta show you. If you haven't watched that video, you should go check that video out. It's probably flying somewhere on the screen. And I'm just gonna start from where I left off, all right? So you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. What's happened since the last video was we've added more data to our operational system. And if you go over to the data flow, the pattern that I created in the last video using a meta table and getting max ID and stuff like that. If we go here and you take a look at this particular query, you'll see that there's new data that's been added to both my orders and my order details table. Alex's pattern can be reused if you have dates or if you have auto incrementing columns. That's what I pointed out in this last video, okay? So if you take a look at these data flows here, and I talked about this in another video, each data flow has a destination and I'm landing these in my warehouse and they're in corresponding staging orders and order detail tables. Let me head over to my data warehouse. Let me close this. Here's my data warehouse. And so you'll see I have a DBO schema, but I also have a staging schema that actually has corresponding tables right here. So you can see there's order details or orders and all my dimensions, right? So I have these tables where when that data flow loads and does the incremental processing, it'll dump that data in there, okay? And so I've configured a pipeline that actually does that. If you go over to my staging pipeline, you can see where it says, hey, we're gonna stage the data. And I showed this in the last video. So it's gonna run that data flow. Then we're gonna update our max IDs. Again, if you don't know what this is, go watch that other video. Instead of just running this individually, I've created a full-on pipeline that'll orchestrate all of the movement of my data. And so the very first step is I've created a stored procedure. And so right now, if you go look at that staging table, it contains data from the previous run. So that data is persisted in my staging tables. Once I run this pipeline, it's gonna clear out those staging tables and it's gonna repopulate using that data flow. So it's only gonna bring in the data, the new data or the data that's changed. For me right now, it's just the new data. And then this stored procedure, this is a really good stored procedure. It just actually loads my dimensions and my facts. Let me show you what this stored procedure looks like. And so you can see this stored procedure is simply gonna run other stored procedures in this order to load all my dimensions and then load my facts. So I can construct this in a way so my fact depends on the keys from those dimensions. So I run all those first and then I load my fact tables up. There's so many ways you can do this. You can do this with a pipeline, you can do this in a notebook. And so let's take a look at what these look like. For the dimensions, the initial run just simply loads the data up using this row number function and it starts at 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm ordering it by the employee ID. And then any subsequent run, what I do is I find the max employee ID, and then I add it to the row number. So if I only have one row, it'll add 1 plus 1 and now I have 2. So it creates a unique surrogate key. The reason I'm using this pattern is the data warehouse in Fabric currently doesn't support identity columns. It's coming, it's coming, it's absolutely coming. But right now, you know, I need to do this pattern to simulate my auto incrementing surrogate key. And so I use the exact same pattern for all my dimensions. And then what I do for my facts, I just insert into my fact table. I'm using both my order and my order details table. I'm using columns from both of those. So I'm gonna join those two together on that order ID. But then I join back on the alternate keys, which are the primary keys from my source system, using the dimension table so that I can get the surrogate keys and load those into my fact tables. And so this particular pipeline right here, when I run this pipeline, it actually takes all that data, it clears my staging tables out, runs a pipeline to load my staging tables, and then it actually loads my data warehouse. And I didn't say that in the last video. I don't know how I forgot all that, but it's really important, right? So that kind of completes the process. Now you may be thinking, well, Patrick, what about the semantic model? Well, that's another video. I can't lump all this into one video, it'd be too long, but we're gonna create a playlist because all my dimensions right now are just type 0, no type 1, no type 2, no type 3. Create some videos on that. And we'll also create some additional videos on what happens to the semantic model. All right, what do you think? You got any questions, any comments? Did you watch the other video? Do you have any questions about this video or that video? I'd love to know. Post it in the comments below. If you wanna know more about Fabric and you know, loading your data warehouse and things like that. There's a video flying above my head. You should probably check that video out. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Duh.